move out. If you get lost, look for me. Stay with me and we'll get through this. We've got to take that beach.
What?
Has enough Bangalores to clear a hole in the wire, but he's pinned behind that Belgian gate down the line. Help Joe's back to our position. We'll give you cover fire. Wait for my order. Covering fire! Go, go, go!
Patterson! I won't make it back with this load of Bangalores unless you give me cover. Stay behind me and keep shooting. Ready? Stay with me, Patterson. And watch the fire from those bunkers.
Quick, Patterson! All right, Jones, let's blow this fence! Fire in the hole! Fire in the hole! We've got cover! Let's get the lead on the other side! Everybody, over the seawall! Get inside that bunker unless we lose the two machine gun nests guarding it. Patterson, if you can make it across that minefield to the turret, you can use it against those nests up there. We'll cover you. Covering fire! Now, Patterson, go now! Watch out! You earned your pay today, Patterson. Now let's move out. Listen up! We need to find a way to signal our cruisers to start lobbing shells! Get to the top of this bunker, and I'll take the other one! Move out! Wait!
Thank you. on it.
Placing you on a special mission. Good luck, Patterson.
June 6, 1944. 175,000 Allied soldiers breached the walls of Fortress Europe through intense German resistance. By late June, Cherbourg had fallen, giving the Allies the port they so desperately needed. By early August, Eisenhower had amassed an Allied army of over 1 million strong. Treacherous field-to-field hedgerow fighting unleashed a breakout across France. With the Germans in full retreat, the Allies marched into Paris. Field Marshal Montgomery moved north into Belgium, while General Patton and the Third Army pushed to the Siegfried Line. It was here that the Allies encountered their newest enemy, the lack of sufficient supplies. Patton's plan was to run straight through the teeth of the Siegfried Line directly to Berlin. Monty had devised a daring airborne operation that had the potential of ending the war by Christmas. Having only enough supplies to support one advance, the fate of thousands rested in the hands of the few. With Allied superiority on land, sea, and air, what could go wrong?
Good morning, Lieutenant Patterson. It's a pleasure to see you again. You're looking well-rested. Good. I'll need you in tip-top shape for your new assignment. You've proven to be quite resourceful, especially your performance most recently in scuttling U-4901. All things considered, you're the ideal candidate for this mission. So let's get down to brass tacks, shall we? The success of the Allied invasion of Normandy prompted an assassination attempt on the Führer. A cadre of high-ranking Nazi leaders planted a bomb during a meeting. Unfortunately, he survived. He's used this attempt on his life to clean house and solidify his power. Whatever remaining sanity the Nazi leadership possessed has been gutted by Hitler's subsequent arrests and executions. He has appointed new leaders more in tune with his insane ideals. That man is bent on sacrificing every last German citizen rather than accept defeat. We need to stop him cold and do it now. Reports from our allies in France suggest that there's been heavy activity in the port of Lorient, a manufacturing facility for their deadly U-boats. It was previously run by one of the would-be assassins. Now Hitler has one of his most trusted advisors in charge. Jimmy, we need to know what's going on at that base. We've arranged for you to be dropped on the outskirts of St. Mathieu, where our 101st Division is still encountering some resistance. Intelligence states that a German U-boat is making an unscheduled resupply stop at the seaport there. Our only opportunity to infiltrate this fortified shipyard is by smuggling you aboard this vessel and waiting until it reaches its port. I know it's tight quarters, Jimmy, but for you, familiar territory. We're sending you back to sea, my boy.
Thank you. me them gears!
Speak or die, I say!
That's all you're getting out of me, crowd.
Useless.